Hello everyone, I'm Yoshitha from India and I'm an engineering final year student studying at BVIT Hyderabad. And I'm very much passionate about blockchain, which made me work on this project called Pollblock. So first of all, I'm very thankful for Fossesha team to give me this opportunity. And I'm here to give a talk on this project called Pollblock. Before actually getting into the project details, I would like to give a brief introduction about blockchain. So we all know that blockchain has got a huge hype in the recent times, and it is, next slide please. Blockchain has got a huge hype in the recent times and it is trending in the field of technology. From its evolution, starting acting as a transaction medium for cryptocurrency, it extended its usage in the field of healthcare, business development, media, and many more. It contributed a lot to the technical development too. And considering the features of transparency and reliability, I've thought this project would be better using this blockchain platform, and also that blockchain has its four main features called immutability, transparency, provenance, and being the single source of truth. Wherein the it's very important for any modern online polling or survey systems, and also that and this platform supports all the four features. And the next slide. So what is Pollblock? Pollblock is an online polling or survey systems. The reason for taking up this problem statement is that when we look at the general online polling or survey systems in the present scenario, there is much scope of manipulation. For example, we can take the case of political parties, wherein the political parties conduct some polls or surveys, and then they spread it only among the supporters or region of their supporters, and using that result, they spread these results among the public. Looking at these results, there is a high chance that the voter may change their thought, which is really bad for the nation. So I've come up with this problem statement, and Pollblock is basically a platform wherein developers can build dApps related to polls or surveys, and these apps can be used by people around the world to provide their vote on the polls or surveys. Next slide, please. Next. So when you talk about how actually Pollblock works, it should be noted that the intermediary results are not revealed to the public, and hence the secrecy is maintained till the deadline. And that in order to reach the wider audience, it can be posted by famous public figures and all. And then this platform provides relevant packages which can be utilized by the developers to build dApps. And the methodology provided by the platform is transparent to the public, and hence it cannot be modified. Even if it is modified, there's going to be an audit trail which will be visible to the public. Next slide. So why blockchain? Blockchain can be used in n number of ways. It can be used widely at the time of elections. It can be used to take public opinion, various public opinions on different government decisions. And blockchain is considered to be immutable. It cannot be changed. So it cannot be changed. And the history of the polls are available in the platform, which can be used whenever we want. And it can only be appended but not updated, which is in tandem with provenance feature. And finally, it is acting as a single source of truth, so it can be used as a legally acceptable platform. Finally, it is expected to be a game changer. Thank you.
Kalidindi, you're up. And Nilima, are you in the room? Please come to the... Oh, right, okay, thank you.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Sahitya from India, and I'm a final year engineering student studying in BVIT Hyderabad. Today, I'm here to talk about my project, Partner in Crime. So in today's world, when everything is digitalized, the criminal records, which are considered to be a very crucial role in the nation's security, are still stored manually. To deal with this issue, I came up with Partner in Crime because they can be manipulated easily. Next slide, please. problem statement, change of data in the FIR. Because the data is stored manually, the FIR can be changed or manipulated in the favor of the offender. Criminal records are not transparent and are not reaching wider audience. Misleading courts with fake test reports. When the judge asks for any forensic test reports or medical test reports, they are manipulated because they are transferred from many hands, middlemen. Police are facing difficulty in finding criminals who are hiding in the hotels, and also this affects the hotel's reputation and creates disturbance to the common people. Next slide, please. Present scenario is the same. Next slide, please. Proposed solution. So as we know, the blockchain is famous for its four important features, immutability, transparency, prominence, and single source of truth. This application has all these four features and is very useful. Next slide, please. Stakeholders. We have six stakeholders in this application: the police, court, CID, hotels, hospitals, and diagnostic centers. And this application acts as single source of truth for all these stakeholders. Next slide, please. So coming to how this application works, the police stores the criminal record and the data into this application. So it cannot be appended. Once the FIR is stored into the application, it cannot be changed or manipulated, but it can be updated. So the history remains the same, and it can be used for future investigations. And this data in the application is stored with shared with the hotel's application. So if any person have to check into the hotel, they need to give their biometric or the iris recognition process method. And if that person has any criminal background, the message alert directly goes to the police, and it doesn't waste time, the police's time, and hotel's reputation also doesn't affect. Also, it helps when the judge asks for any test reports. The lab assistants can directly upload this into this application without giving or transferring it with any middlemen. So it decreases the rate of scope of manipulation. And the judge can directly see it or refer to the result as soon as the lab assistant uploads the result. Next slide, please. Future scope, I would like to connect this with IoT by when the judge asks for any test reports, the machine, once the machine is produces the result, it's directly stored to the into the application. So even the lab assistant has no scope up, or he doesn't have a chance to manipulate it. So it's directly from the machine into the application and to the judge. So it completely eliminates middlemen and the manipulation. Next slide, please. Thank you. You have any doubts, you can come to me personally.